Hi, I'm Val Quinn from Gadget Guy. So we have all the latest from Apple's peak performance event just in. And there's lots of performance tweaks to old favorites in the Apple range, plus some all new gear that's tipped to change the game when it comes to personal computing power. So let's check it out. Okay, first cab off the rank is an update to Apple's lowest priced iPhone, the SE model. So this gets the latest A15 Bionic processor, and that's found in the latest iPhone 13 and in the 13 Pro. This is kind of like cramming in a V12 engine into a compact car, and it brings loads of power for things like fast app switching, scrolling through photos, that live text feature that allows you to cut and paste text out of your photos, and even the computational photography stuff, which is essentially a lot of post-processing effects to improve night shots, to make colors look better, skin tones more accurate, and add all kinds of effects like shallow depth of field to your photos. So the camera gets it's an upgraded 12 megapixel camera, and that's on the front and back, but we don't see the new center stage feature, which this is used for video calls, and it centers the frame on all of the people that are in the camera's view, which is really cool. The ME also gets 5G connectivity, but there's no mention of Wi-Fi 6, so I don't think that's included. Also, you'll see the same 4.7-inch screen and the physical Touch ID button, just like the old SE model. And I really thought there could be a chance here of a full-size screen like you'd get with Android phones at a similar price point. So the iPhone SE will be available in 64GB, 128GB, and 256GB models, and the colors are Midnight and Starlight and the product Red. Prices start at Australian $719 or $429 for you guys in the US. So this is their lowest price point of all. In the jungle. Speaking of colors, Apple also showed off its new green color option for the iPhone 13 and an alpine green for the iPhone 13 Pro and Max models. We're also seeing a performance focus bump in the fifth generation of the iPad Air. So this now comes with Apple's M1 chip, and that's the same chip that it uses in some of its entry-level laptops. So that's a pretty big bump there. And it's exactly the same M1 as the one that you'd find in the iPad Pro. So really, with the new iPad Air, there's a huge amount of bang for your buck. It's meant to be 60% faster than the previous Air model thanks to the M1 chip. And Apple even says that the fifth generation iPad Air is twice as fast as the best Windows laptop in its price range. So that will be interesting for us to test out here at Gadget Guy. Otherwise, the Air gets 5G and Wi-Fi 6 support. And there's now a 12 megapixel ultra-wide camera on the front, and that does support center stage for video conferencing. And you can now use Apple's second generation Pencil with it as well, and that will attach to the side with a little magnet, and it will recharge directly from that connection as well. I'm also really happy to see that there's a USB-C port on the bottom, which is twice as fast as the version before. And prices start at $929 Australian or from $599 in the US. Next up, Apple is giving professional developers and content creators some actual love here. So there's now a new chip in addition to Apple's M1 range, and this one is called the M1 Ultra. So this is essentially two M1 Max chips, and that's currently their most powerful version of the chip, and they're fused together. And the magic happens because there is a direct communication between the two chips, which is called Ultra Fusion, and that doesn't get bogged down by slower connections to memory or graphics like its competitors sort of dual or quad chips would. It also behaves like a single chip, so there's no software tweaks needed to take full advantage of the extra processing power, meaning that all the apps that are natively done for the M1 will work exactly as they should. And lastly, the M1's power per watt efficiency really does help it set it apart because it can outperform most of the older iMacs and the Mac Pro, but using considerably less, even 200 watts less of power. And there's 128 gigabytes of unified memory, and this can be shared between the CPU and graphics processing. And that, if you compare it to the most powerful graphics card on the market, which has 48 gigabytes, is really a huge amount more. And the Ultra is 8 times faster than the standard M1, which has already been really well received in the PC community. So what devices will we find this new M1 Ultra chip in anyway? Well, that takes us to Apple's next big reveal, which is an all-new computer called the Mac Studio. Now, this kind of resembles a taller Mac Mini, and you get a choice of either an M1 Max or an M1 Ultra chip inside. And the device itself is designed with advanced cooling and lots of connectivity options. And the idea is that it will enable you to build your own studio around it. I mean, it can even support up to 4 Pro XDR displays, now those are the 6K ones, plus a 4K TV, all from one device. So you can imagine all of the options you're gonna have in terms of what you plug into it. So the Studio is meant to be a lot faster than the fastest iMac and high-powered Mac Pros, and I'll put some of their comparisons up on screen about just how fast it is. So costs start in Australia at $3,099 or US $1,999, but it just goes up. Like the next step starts at $6,099 for the Ultra version, and then you can spec it up to over $12,000 or $13,000 depending on the size of your hard drives and all kinds of other things. All up, the Mac Studio looks to be the most powerful personal computer that you can buy right now, and that's a big claim. Apple says that it can handle 18 streams of ProRes 422 video to be edited at once, and apparently no other computer can do that right now. And look, to watch all of these video streams, Apple has a new Studio Display Monitor too, which I'm really excited about. So this joins Apple's incredibly expensive and high-end Pro XDR display. This thing costs about $9,000 in Australia and goes even higher than that. The Studio display is 27 inches. It has thicker bezels around the screen than the XDR version. It's also a 5K screen with 14.7 million pixels. And for the creatives out there, it's a P3 wide color screen. It's got 600 nits of brightness and about 1 billion colors. This isn't a mini LED type screen, however, and I know that a bunch of us were thinking that that might come along, but it looks like it's a normal IPS type of screen. So the monitor comes with something unique. It actually has an A13 Bionic chip inside it, and that's taken from a couple generations of iPhone ago. And what this chip does is it adds processing support for the built-in FaceTime camera, which is a 12 megapixel ultra-wide camera, and it can handle center stage regardless of the Mac or device that you're connecting it to. There's also a 3-mic array for improved audio and background noise cancellation. And the other thing is the Studio display has 6 speakers, and that allows it to do spatial sound, and that includes Dolby Atmos support. So that's another thing that that chip helps it do. The display has a few stand options. There's one that tilts 30 degrees. There's another one that can tilt as well as raise and lower. And there's an option too for a nano textured glass, which is great for environments where you have a lot of overhead or background lights. In terms of connectivity, there's lots of connectors on the back, including a 96 watt USB-C connector, which is designed to be able to fast charge the new MacBook Pros that are plugged into it. And then you can daisy chain up to 3 other monitors as well, I believe. But sadly, Apple's least expensive Studio display is still expensive at $2,499 Australian or $1,599 in the US. Okay, so that's the latest on Apple's peak performance announcements. So you can pre-order most of the things on Friday and they go on sale on March the 18th. Also, hop onto Apple's website and you can catch all the details about the new products there too. This is Val Quinn for Gadget Guy, and we'll catch you later.